Welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. I welcome you all to my channel. In this session, we are going to discuss a very interesting topic, that is about the building blocks of various types of the creams like vanishing creams, cold creams, moisturizing creams. We are going to learn in this module about what are the building blocks and the components and the compositions used in the formulation of these different kinds of the creams, as well as their evaluation test. So let us begin. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further updates and notification about the different lecture series. So what are creams? Creams are basically the semi-solid dosage forms. So they again have the two components. First is the dispersed phase and another is the dispersion medium. So again, they can be oil by water types or water by oil types. So there are different kinds of the creams. Creams are used very widely in different parts of the world, different types of the creams. Creams are generally applied on the type of the skin. So again, there are different applicabilities and the different kinds of the creams. So let us try to understand what are the different kinds of the creams. Although there are so many numbers of the creams, but I have classified them into few categories. For example, the first are the makeup creams. In this lies our vanishing creams, foundation creams. Then second are the cleansing creams. Once the makeup has to be removed, that is to be with the help of the various kinds of the cleansing creams. Then third category lies the creams which are used specifically in the winters, because in winter we have more dry skin. Since the weather and the humidity conditions, the skin is more dry, you need special kinds of the cream known as the cold creams. Then another sort of the category of the creams are the dry skin. So few people have very dry skin because of their profession or like because of their different exposure to the temperature conditions. If the water vapor is happening more from the top layer, water is getting evaporated more from the top layers, the skin feels dehydrated and the skin has the dry skin features. So if the skin becomes dry again, then it gives special characteristics features like itchiness or like in deficiency of the moisturization. So in that case, you need additional moisturization. For that, special creams are formulated which are known as the moisturizing creams. Then also there are other types of the creams like all-purpose creams, which can be used in throughout the year or in different weather conditions, or like night creams, which are specifically designed to have some improvement effects, and they are being applied and in the night so that they can have a more stay period. Then other types of the skin creams are like skin protective creams and specifically designed for the hand creams. So these was about the different types of the cream. Now let us try to understand what are the different formulation components, what are the creams made up of, then what are the actual chemical constituents being used generally into the formulation of these different kinds of the cream. So like, it is up to the manufacturer what kind of the cream is actually his manufacturing. It depends on other factors as well, but when we talk about the general formulation of the creams, these are the specific ingredients which are widely used in the formulations of these types of moisturizing creams, vanishing creams, for the dry skin, all purpose creams, hand creams, etc. So let us try to understand them one by one. So as I have told, there are two phases in the creams. First is the oily phase and second is the aqueous phase. So when we talk about the aqueous phase, that means we need water as one of the components. Then second are the different substances like oils, fats and waxes. They primarily make up our oily phase. So oily phase can be made up by these three constituents, which are like different kinds of the oils. So when we talk about the oils, we have mineral oil, and mineral oil, it can be again like light liquid paraffins or like heavy liquid paraffins. Then glyceride oils, you must have seen herbal oils like almond oil, arachis oil, castor oil. They're widely used in different types of the creams. Then fats, when we talk about the fats, basically generally the fat used is of like chloric, palmitic, stearic acids, sesame oil, olive oil, cacao butter, peanut oil, and other types of the oily substances are also created by waxes. So oils, fats and waxes basically constitutes the creams. Like waxes is like beeswax, borax combination is widely used in the cold creams, carnauba wax. Then other type of the lanolin. Lanolin is very important during the formulation of the creams. Lanolin is generally derived from the wool fat. Then other substances are like glycols. ke thylene glycol, diethylene glycol, propylene glycols, they are basically acting as a humectants. Then you must have seen different creams are of different colors. These colors are being imparted to them by using some natural or like synthetic colors. For example, the saffron, chlorophyll, cochineal. So these are the basic common ingredients used in different kinds of the creams. So next, other constituents which are used in the formulation of the creams are like emollients. Emollients are actually, they provide the moisturization effect. They penetrate into the skin and they enhances the skin hydration levels. For example, different types of the moisturizers like mineral oils, squalene, lanolin derivatives. Then there are other emulsifying agents. They can again be like inorganic solids, for example, bentonite, kaolin, or like gums and proteins, for example, gum arabic, gum tragacanth, gelatin, sometimes agalbumin is also used. So these are the different substances which are used in the preparation of the creams. Other substances which are used in the formulation of cream is the wetting agent. Wetting agents are generally the substances which are actually added to lower down the surface tension of the final cream, or to lower it is a type of a surface active agent which actually decreases the surface tensions. So the generally used substances, chemical composition substances, are like soaps or sulfonated oils, fatty alcohol sulfates, sulfated esters and amides. Other substances which are being added during the formulation of the creams are like humectants, which actually increases the hydration levels. For example, different kinds of the proteins, acids, polysaccharides. Apart from them, the other fragrances, substances like perfumes are being added to give them a specific specific odor, specific perfumes like white blossoms, rosy days, orange blossoms. And sometimes there are some functional raw materials like vitamins. For example, when you go for the manufacturing of the cosmeceuticals, are being added up like vitamins, amino acids, anti-inflammatory agents are also being incorporated into creams. These substances are added to actually penetrate deep inside the and they actually repairs down the skin. If some problem is there, some skin condition is there, skin rashes are there, so these constituents actually help them in removing these kinds of the problems. So you have seen there are n number of the components which are being added up to the cream. These vitamins, these other types of the substance actually help in repairing the skin. They give such a hydration, they increases the hydration level, improves moisturization, so that the skin has some glow properties. Now let us try to understand the different kinds of the creams. In this video, in this session, I am going to discuss about three types of the creams. First is the moisturizing cream, second is the vanishing cream, and third is the cold creams. So let us discuss them one by one. First is the moisturizing cream. As I have discussed earlier, moisturizing creams are actually used to increase the hydration level of the skin. Sometimes you must have seen that few people have very much dry skin, either due to their profession or like they are being more exposed to the sun, which happens that the evaporation from the top layer is more and they are not getting so much amount of hydration from the lower layer. So what happens if the top layer of the skin becomes more dehydrated? The hydration level can be increased by the use of these moisturizing creams. These moisturizing creams have humectants, these moisturizing creams have the oily substituents more, so that the hydration level is being increased, and moreover it also prevents further evaporation from the skin. So you must have seen some itchy skins. If you apply the moisturizing cream regularly, the person feels better, the person feel more comfortable, and these creams are actually able to restore water or moisture and plasticizes the stratum corneum, that is the top layer, and also provides actually some sort of flexibility and makes the skin soft. So these types of the creams are known as the moisturizing creams. So when we talk about the formula of the moisturizing creams, this is a typical formula for the moisturizing creams: stearic acid, mineral oil, lanolin, glyceryl monostearate, isopropyl myristate, glycerin, propylene glycol, triethanolamine, water, perfumes and preservatives. So you can see again there are two phases. oily phase and the aqueous phase. So oily phase comprises of your mineral oil, lanolin, and your aqueous phase comprises of your stearic acid, water, and along in the combination with other type of the ingredients like glyceryl monostearate, which is used for emulsification, or like triethanol, I mean perfumes and preservatives, glycerin is added as a humectant so as to preserve the natural moisture of the skin. So these skins are being formulated using these substances. So next we are going to understand about the vanishing creams. So as the name indicates, vanishing, as you apply this cream and you spread it uniformly, you will feel that after some time it actually disappears. So these creams spread very easily, they disappear once they are being rubbed on the skins, and therefore they are known as the vanishing creams. So as the term indicate, vanishing, it means it quickly disappears. Now why it disappears? Because in this type of the semi-solid dosage forms, it is about the oil by water type. So since the oil is the dispersed phase and water is the dispersion medium, as you rub down on the layers of the skin, the water actually goes off and it actually fades down. So the watery layer actually evaporates easily and therefore it vanishes out from the skin. So these creams are composed of the emollients, esters, which leave little apparent film on the skin. So as compared to the other cold creams, this is generally being asked, what is the difference between cold cream and the vanishing cream? Cold cream is a water by oil type of the emulsion, whereby the dispersion medium is the oil and dispersed phase is the water. So as you apply, the layer, the oily layer sticks to the skin. So this is, therefore it is being used in the winter. So as the water evaporates and the oily phase sticks on the skin, it gives a cooling sensation. That is why it is known as the cold cream. But when you talk about the vanishing creams, in this case the water evaporates and you have not that type of the film adhering to the skin, so it quickly vanishes away. So these creams are generally composed of the emollient esters, which leave little apparent film on the skin. So traditional formula of the vanishing creams are based on stearic acid. Yes friends, the stearic acid is one of the main important components when we talk about the vanishing creams. So stearic acid melts above the body temperature and it crystallizes in a form so as to be invincible, providing a non-greasy film. It also imparts attractive appearance to the cream. So I hope now you are clear about the difference between cold cream and the vanishing cream. I am repeating again, cold cream is a water by oil type cream. So when you apply the cold cream, the water evaporates, leaving an oily layer above the skin, thick oily layer, which gives you a cooling sensation. So that is why it is known as the cold cream. But when you talk about the vanishing cream, they are just opposite. They are oil by water type of the emulsion, whereby the water evaporates. So there is not any sort of the film over the skin. Since it vanishes easily, since it disappears, it is known as the vanishing creams. The main component of the vanishing cream is the stearic acid. When you talk about the formulation of the vanishing creams, they are basically composed of the stearic acid in composition with the alkalis like potassium hydroxide, humectants like glycerin, water, perfumes and preservatives. So let us now try to understand the preparation of the vanishing creams. So again, you have to melt the stearic acid in a beaker. Then you can dissolve this potassium hydroxide and you have to heat this aqueous phase up to 70 degrees Celsius on a water bath. So when both aqueous phase and oily phase reaches the same temperature, that is 70 degrees Celsius, the aqueous phase is melted and added to the stearic acid with the constant stirring. So other ingredients are added once they reaches to cools down to the 40 degrees Celsius. So then so that you can get a homogeneous cream which is being opted. So friends, I would like to explain here is that the general formula for the preparation of creams is common among all them. You have a oily phase, you have an aqueous phase, you heat up both the phases, then once they achieve the 70 degrees Celsius, you mix them both, aqueous phase and the oily phase, then you allow them to cool down while continuous doing the stirring. You allow it to cool down and reach the temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. Once they reaches to the 40 degrees Celsius, you add other components like humectants, perfumes, fragrance, other constituents are being added up, and then they are allowed to cool down and then they are stored into the packaging containers. So I hope you are clear about the formulation and preparation of the vanishing creams. Next, we move on to the cold creams. So, cold creams is a water by type of the emulsion, which is when applied to the skin gives a cooling effect due to the evaporation of water present in the emulsion. So, cold cream is an emulsion of fats and water which can be used to clean and soften down the skin. So, cold cream has been used to remove the makeups gently at the end of the day, and it can also be used to soften the toughened skin on the knees, elbows, or to keep the skin protected from the harsh winter conditions. So again, they are prepared by the saponification reaction between beeswax and alkali borax. So it is again produced by the saponification process. Next, let us try to understand and see the formula for the cold cream. Cold creams are generally composed of white beeswax, liquid paraffin in combination with the borax, rose oil and water. This is the simplest formula. You again have to melt down the aqueous phase and the oily phase until they achieve the temperature of 70 degrees Celsius. Then you gradually and mix the both the phases and drop by drop, so that with the continuous straining, so that you get a white color type of the cream. So you continuously keep on straining until you it lowers down the temperature to 40 to 45 degrees Celsius. Once it reaches, then you add your rose oil and other fragrances and perfumes at this temperature until a homogeneous semi-solid mass is being obtained. So the preparation of creams is very simple. You have an oily phase, you aqueous phase, you heat them to at 70 degrees Celsius. Once, then you mix them gradually, slowly, drop by drop with continuous stirring until they drop down to the temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. Once they achieve the 40 to 45 degrees Celsius, then you add fragrances, perfumes, oils, etc. Fragrances and perfumes at the last, and then you keep on stirring until you get a semi-solid homogeneous mass. Next, we move on to the evaluation of the creams. So, when we discuss about the evaluation of the creams, the creams have to be evaluated for certain parameters like the presence of foreign particles or grittiness. You must have seen while you use the scrubs, you feel that grittiness. This type of grittiness is not expected for the creams. So, creams should be very smooth, homogeneous mixture. So, to test that, a small amount of the cream is taken and spread on a glass slide free from the grease and is checked for the presence of any foreign particles against the diffused light. Then the other parameters which are being used for the evaluation of creams, like pH of the cream. So the pH of different formulations is determined using the digital pH meter, or the viscosity of the formulations. The viscosity of the creams have to be homogeneous throughout the batch. So it is being checked by the use of the various Brookfield viscometers at different RPM and temperature conditions, and these are being recorded. Other parameters of evaluation of creams are like spreadability. So for this, you take the two glass slides of same dimensions, then you place cream on one of them and the slide with the other tube, so that the cream between two slides are being pressed uniformly to form a thin layer. So the spreadability is expressed in terms of the time taken by two slides to slip off from the cream. So lesser the time taken for the separation of two slides, better is the spreadability. So this again is a very important test for the evaluation of the creams. The other types of the test which are being used is like irritancy test and the patch test to check for the sensitivity part of the skin. Irritancy test is used to check for the presence of any sort of erythema or edema on the skin, and it is being checked for 24 hours. Patch test is being done to check the sensitivity of the skin. This is a mandatory test to be done for any sort of the creamy formulations. These are the standard guidelines. Like stability test is very important. So how much extent your formulation remains stable. Since it is being composed of two different phases, so we have to check continuously for any sort of the phase separations. Like in suspensions, you must have seen that phase separations takes place once they are during the stability studies. So we conduct the stability studies for creams as well to check for the phase separation or any other sort of, so that it remains stable during the shelf life. Other sorts of the study evaluations are like partition coefficient of the cream in different solvents, extrudability. This is a test to check out that how much amount of the cream is able to extrude from the tube. So again, these tests are being evaluated as per the guidelines established by the Bureau of Indian Standards. They give guidelines for the extrudability for the packaging efficacy test. Then other sorts of evaluations are like thermal stability. So the formulated cream is inserted into a glass bottle with the help of a spatula and tapped to settle down to the bottom, filled up to the 2/3 of the bottle, and insert, plug and tighten the cap. So once it is filled, it is then kept in the incubator at 45 degrees Celsius for 48 hours. The sample will pass the test. If on removal from the incubator, it shows no oil separation or any other sort of the phase. Friends, these tests is very important because stability is very important parameters when we talk about any sort of the two different phases, because this is a common problem being reported. There should not be any sort of the phase separation, otherwise it will be of no use. So the dispersed phase has to be within the dispersion medium with a very good stirring with it for a prolonged period. It has to be tested on very ethically. This is one of the most important tests for any creams. So now we are at the end of the session. I hope you are now clear about the different kinds of the creams, like moisturizing creams, cold creams and vanishing creams. The differences are asked about almost all of the time. You must be clear about the formulation components of the cold cream, vanishing creams, differences between vanishing creams and cold creams. So I hope this helps you. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please like and share to my and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further updates and notification about this. Thank you so much, everyone.